A search and rescue mission is underway to find more than 300 Nigerian girls who were taken from their school on Friday. So for more, let's go to Stephanie Busari, who joins me from Lagos. Stephanie, how is the Nigerian president and Nigerians reacting to this?
Well, as you can imagine, Kim, there was shock and outrage that this has happened again. This is, after all, the third kidnapping in as many months from a school in this particular region of northwest Nigeria. The president has come out and issued a hardline statement saying that the terrorists and kidnappers cannot believe that they're more powerful than the Nigerian government and that they will take a hardline stance against this kidnappings. But Nigerians have been hearing this for 7 years. They've been hearing this, the previous administration, this administration, and parents are just asking, how can we keep our children safe when we send them to school? And we've been to the area where this latest kidnapping has happened, where more than 300 girls, 317 exactly, we're told, were taken in the early hours of Friday morning. We've been talking to some parents there. Take a listen to what they had to say. A teenage girl, just 16 years old. Until Friday, she was a high school student in northwestern Nigeria. Now, Khadija Abubakar and more than 300 of her classmates are missing. Men armed with guns raided their school in Jangebe early Friday morning. A government official tells CNN they arrived here at the school on about 20 motorcycles just after 1 a.m. Hamsia was lucky. She narrowly escaped being abducted. I got afraid when I saw them running in, shouting and shooting, she says. She's afraid to ever return to school again. Jumai Haruna's daughter, Habsat, was among those taken. She believes she was grabbed in her pajamas, a hijab left behind for her mother to find. By Allah's name, there is no security, she says. If there was, this would not happen. Even if God brings back her daughter, Haruna says she will never allow her to return to school. The state police say they have launched a heavily armed search and rescue operation. In April 2014, 276 girls were abducted from Chibok in northeastern Nigeria by Boko Haram, an Islamic extremist group whose name translates to Western education is forbidden in a local language. It sparked a global movement, bring back our girls. Scores would escape or later be freed. Nearly 7 years later, more than 100 of these girls are still missing. After my colleague Nema El-Bagir showed a proof of life video to the Chibok girls' families in 2016, CNN confronted President Muhammadu Buhari.
Why didn't the government share this information with them?
I haven't seen that video. But even if I see it, I will be very careful about showing it to the family. There's no point to fraudulently raise hope of the families if you can't beat them. I saw the families as a group twice. One, they came to visit my wife. Two, they came as a group to see me. And the less I see them, the better for my own, emotional balance.
It makes you sad.
Yes, I try to imagine my 14-year-old daughter, 14 to 18, missing for more than 2 years, trying to imagine what condition are they in.
There you have it, Kim. There is no security. That is the prevailing feeling here that many Nigerians are feeling in the wake of these spate of kidnappings. Kim.
Yeah, tragic. All right. Thank you so much, Stephanie Busari in Lagos.